Hi everyone, it's Philip from England, and I'm ready to take any IELTS questions that anyone may have. Okay, so it looks like I'm the only person here at the moment, so I'll probably just go ahead and tell a few people in some different forums or something like that to try and get more people to attend. Okay, message from Facebook. You're live. We're building an audience for you. Oh, excellent. Thank you very much for that. I do appreciate that. Okay, so I'm just waiting. Just going to paste into some other forums about the free webinar I'm doing at the moment. Let me see here. Still the only person. Keep going. We're telling your followers to join your video. Okay, very helpful from Facebook. Thank you for that. And right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to also share from my company page into the group. Oh, hi, there's one person here already. A message from Facebook. We're still spreading the word that you're live. This may take a minute. Very helpful. Thank you very much. And just waiting for them to go ahead with that. Okay. So I'm just going here and sharing the webinar that I'm doing at the moment. So groups, okay, sharing a couple of groups that I'm the admin of, and rights, okay, that's the first one. So I've just shared in there, and also I'm going to share in the other place that I'm I'm an admin. Let me see here. Oh, in fact, actually not, I'm the admin, I run that one. The other one, I'm just an administrator. Right, okay, there's one person here. Welcome to the conversation. So this is Philip from England. I'm a UK native English teacher. I was born and went to school in England. And so if you have a question about the IELTS or you know, anything like that, please go ahead and ask, and I'm ready to answer. Oh, there are four people here, so great. Maybe I shouldn't be so surprised. It is a... okay, so if anyone has a question, let me just go back here and check. Five people here. Oh, lots. Well, not a huge amount, but more than maybe usually. Six now. Oh, it's really going up, but it kind of... Before it kind of goes a little bit higher and then sometimes lower. So hopefully, well, we'll see what happens. Okay, let me see here. Just working on sharing the window, sharing the... Right, I'm gonna, if anyone has any question, please go ahead and ask. There are five people here, which is maybe a little bit popular for my webinars. or maybe I was doing it at the wrong time. That's probably the issue is for me, perhaps to some extent. And I'm doing when everyone's asleep or busy or something. Okay, anyway, so if anyone has a question about English, please go ahead and ask. This is Philip from England. I'm a UK native speaker, and I first started teaching the IELTS about 8 years ago, right? So if anyone has a question about the IELTS exam and you would like an answer, I may know the answer because I've been teaching it for many years. So... right, okay, I have a free ebook. The link is at the top. Oops, oh, what have I done there? Shared. Right, well, I'm probably gonna go ahead and just give some tips about the IELTS. And if anyone has any questions anytime, please go ahead and ask. But I'll just go ahead and start giving tips myself. And then if anybody does want to ask a question, please go ahead. Okay, so if you have a question, please ask. I'm just going to start giving tips about the IELTS. Let's start with the tips for the reading exam. So for the reading exam, trying to make a schedule. So, for example, you're going to be for the reading exam, make a schedule. So, for example, you will read the questions for 3 minutes. Then you will read the text for 7 minutes, underlining and making bullet points. Then you will answer for 7 minutes, and then 2 minutes checking and 1 minute final check. So I'll just repeat that again, and maybe give a bit more information also I missed. So for the reading exam tips, you can make a schedule, and you can read the questions for 3 minutes, underlining keywords and making bullet points next to the keywords, and put them on the text. Then you can read the text for 7 minutes, underlining keywords and making bullet points next to the paragraphs, etc. And then you can answer the questions for 7 minutes, and then you can check for 2 minutes and then do 1 minute final checking at the end. So that would be good. What I recommend for everybody is try to underline and the text keywords and make bullet points, because it's quite difficult to check, especially perhaps for the academic reading. It's quite difficult to read it twice, you know, probably even for a native teacher or native speaker who's quite, you know, got a lot of experience, it'd be quite difficult to read the text twice in the 20 minutes and so on. Okay, right, I have a comment. This is from Sarah Mariam. Hi, Sarah, nice to meet you. And if you have a question, please go ahead and ask. This is I am Philip from England, and I'm a UK native speaker. And I first started teaching the IELTS about 8 years ago, approximately, maybe slightly under, approximately 8 years. And I specialize in IELTS. So if anyone has a question, please go ahead. I'm just giving tips at the moment for the IELTS exam. And if anyone has a specific question, please go ahead. Right, so I was just speaking about the IELTS reading. And so for the IELTS reading exam, make sure to do a lot of practice exams, like regularly, and become familiar with the structure. You need to also move very fast, so that can take some practice. For the question, make sure it's, you know, you are answering exactly. Oh, I have a question. Hello, teacher. I'm Emmanuel from Colombia. Nice to meet you. Could you recommend some interesting websites where we could be constantly practicing for this type of exams? Yes, excellent question. There is a website. It's called IELTSexam.net. Actually, I'm not sure I've got the correct spot on there. IELTSexam.net. This has a lot of reading and listening exams. Now, it is free. I'm assuming it's legal. I mean, I'm assuming it'll be closed down by IELTS. It's a very old website. And the questions they have there are quite old. So I'm assuming it's legal. Although, you know, as I say, it's very old, so IELTS would have closed it down if they'd known about it. It's such an old website. That's one website where you can practice for that, for listening and reading exams, and, you know. And there's also another good website, which is free as well, and this is called IELTSblog.com. And from this website, when people take the speaking exam, they email the speaking exam to the website, basically you can kind of see the recent exams. So that's a website I recommend a lot. Of course, there's also a lot of other useful websites which have a lot of free information about them. free information on them. I actually have written a free ebook as well. So if anyone wants to download that, you can download that for free from my website, which also has from my free website, which also has other free stuff. So if you're interested in that, you can check it out. Okay, excellent question there, and seeing if I answered it. Interesting website you can get constantly practicing. Yes, so I definitely recommend for the reading and listening. I probably recommend to do lots of regular practice. You know, it just takes time sometimes to train the mind for listening and reading, and also of course for speaking and writing. Do regular practice exams as well. That can take some time. Okay, right. So if anyone has a question, please go ahead and ask. Otherwise, I'll keep giving some tips for the IELTS exam. Right, I'm on reading IELTS tips at the moment. And any more questions from Emmanuel or Sarah, please go ahead and ask, and I'm happy to answer. Right. Next tip is about I'm on reading at the moment. So some people, they have difficulty with reading for the question types. So what I recommend is, if you have if you have difficulty for example, true, false, not given, when you're formatting the text, try to do that at the same time. So that can help to prioritize the true, false, and not given. Okay, right. I'm trying to think. Also, for the reading exam, make sure that you're familiar with the different types of questions that are there. There are different question types, so it can be useful to become familiar with the different types of questions that are in the reading exam. Okay, great. I was gonna put a link for my free forum that I run about the IELTS. So if anyone's interested in joining that, here is the link. Okay, right. I'm going to go ahead now for the next tip. Probably can stick with reading, I guess. Just thinking here. For the reading, make sure you answer all the questions. If you don't answer the question, of course, You can guess it probably, although maybe you shouldn't. If you guess it, you can still perhaps get a mark or just give your best idea. So there is a little bit of chance there. Also, make sure that you have a schedule so that you're not, careful of the time, so that you're not running out of time for the reading and you only find you have a short amount of time left as well. Okay, right. Any questions from anyone, please go ahead. Otherwise, I'll keep on giving tips. This is Philip from England, UK native speaker, and I first started teaching the IELTS about 8 years ago. And I have free material, like a free ebook, free forum, etc., free material, and also Skype classes, writing homework, correction, and so on, and e-courses, and a forum, support, private support forum. So it's onlineenglishteacher.com if you're interested in that. And my email is info@onlineenglishteacher.com, and Skype ID is IELTS Online English Teacher. So I specialize in the IELTS. Right, okay, I'm going ahead for the next tip. So I've been doing about reading. I'm not sure how many more reading tips I have from memory. Okay, so let's go ahead now for listening. And for the listening exam, like the reading exam, make sure that you do plenty of practice exams so that you are familiar with the types of questions, and also that you have a skill to go at a reasonable speed. Also for the listening exam, it'll come through the practice exams, but also try to listen to different nationalities and ages and genders, American man English, British man English, etc. So basically, you are getting experience with the different accents. So it'd be easier. It's possible it may be Australian accents. I think I was reading on the website or something that they try to make different accents. So just get a variety of accents. And you can also just search on YouTube, like Australian news or American news, British news, you know, listen to some presenters. And that can help with that. Okay, right. Very good. And let me see here. I've got a couple of updates here. Okay, someone is asked to join the free forum. Yes, welcome to that. Hi, everyone. It's Philip from England. My website is onlineenglishteacher.com. If you're interested in paid Skype classes or e-courses, private forum, or writing homework, also have free materials, free ebook, etc. Right, okay, I'm just giving tips, and if you have any questions, please do ask. I'm going to carry on giving tips otherwise. So the next tip that I'm going to give for is for listening. So for the list, and there are lots of free tips in my free ebook. You can read through that as well. I'm just doing this from memory. Now, tips for listening, for the listening exam. Basically, you can make notes for the listening exam, and then you need to transfer the notes to the question paper in the last 10 minutes. The listening exam is 30 minutes. From memory, it's 30 minutes and then 10 minutes transfer time. So you can transfer the answers to the answer sheet in the last 10 minutes. When you're listening, read ahead to anticipate the questions. So if the question will be something like, which year do they finish university? Then you know you're going to need to be listening to like the year. Another tip for the listening is follow the instructions carefully. You know, if they say, whatever, write such and such words, numbers, whatever, you need to just follow that carefully. For the listening exam, it's only spoken once, as I remember. So you can't go back, so you kind of got to get it the first time. And therefore, if you do lots of practice listening exams, you can kind of hopefully pick up the speed a bit. More tips for the listening exam are. Let me think here for the moment. Understand the different sections. So there are four sections, and one of them will be part one. I can't remember exactly. I need to check my ebook. But there's perhaps like a dialogue or like a monologue and like three or four people, all this kind of stuff. So have a look, have a listen, and become familiar with that. Okay, just seeing, I've got a couple of updates here from Facebook. Comment on your Facebook. Okay, great. So someone's making a comment here, maybe it's a question. Skype speaking session available with you. Right. Yes, definitely. So if you're interested in, these are normally for payment, although I do free stuff like this free webinar and free ebook and other stuff. I also have paid Skype classes. So if you're interested in that, I can give this. And actually, I have a discount for single student classes at the moment. It's like a 50% discount. So if you want to go to my Facebook page rather here, you can like that and check out the offer that's there. And any questions, just let me know. So I do Skype training. It's for payment and for private training. And I actually have a 50% discount for Skype classes, which is today and finishing tomorrow. So if you'd like to do that, you can just let me know. Okay, hi everyone. It's Philip from England. I'm a UK native speaker, and I've been teaching English online for I started over 10 years ago, so I'm very experienced with grammar, etc. Okay, very good. Right, let's go ahead. If anyone has a question, please write it. Otherwise, I'm going to go and carry on with tips. So let's go ahead now for tips for writing. So there are many tips available for writing. So, for example, the first one is become familiar with writing with a pen or pencil. Most people, they don't use. Now, all these tips I'm just doing for memory, but I do have a free ebook. A lot of the tips, or most of them, will be in the free ebook. And I'll give the link for that if you want to download it. It's 100% free. So for writing for the IELTS exam, many people are not familiar with writing with a pen or pencil. You know, maybe many years since they were at a school. So basically, you can practice writing with a pen or pencil, and just trying to pick up the speed, and also make sure that you are writing clearly. So you want to make sure that every letter and every word is clear. And if you make an error with a pen or the pencil, you can erase it. With a pen, you can cross it out. Don't overwrite the letters probably or words, because it can just become a bit confusing for the examiner. Okay, and next tip for the writing exam is make sure you have time for checking. So what I recommend is the best is like 5 minutes checking for task one and 10 minutes for task two. Probably that's very hard for most people, but definitely have time for checking. I don't recommend checking as you're going. You know, I mean, I don't know. I'm not sure. Some people say that they write one paragraph and check or something. Probably what I recommend is just schedule in time for checking or whatever works best for you. But basically checking, how you do it, checking is very important. Also for the writing exam, make an Excel sheet, and in the Excel sheet, count the error. If you have a teacher correcting you, count the errors that you are making and then see the patterns that you are repeating. So basically, you don't want to repeat the errors very much if possible. So that's a tip for the writing. Also for the writing, think about the number of paragraphs you want. So basically, you'll need 3 paragraphs for task 1 and 4 paragraphs for task 2. So be careful about. Think about the structure. Normally, what I recommend is like having approximately 4 sentences for each paragraph for the task 2, and then 2 to 3 sentences for most paragraphs for the task 1. So therefore, for the task 2, you wrote about 16 sentences, and you know, for the task 1, approximately 6 to 9 sentences, I guess. For the writing exam, for the task 1. Academic, you can learn a lot of phrases, such as increase, decrease, and so on, and phrases like looking at the data provided beneath, we can perceive, blah, 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 blah. And these are actually in my e-courses, so you can check them out there. And what I like to do is I like to use idioms for the IELTS exam. So basically, you can use a lot of idioms if possible. I recommend, for example, for the task 2, about 1 idiom for each paragraph. So there'll be about 4 idioms as a minimum if possible. And for the task 1 general, about 3 idioms. So so if you use idioms, you need to use them carefully so they're not, you know, too informal or something like that. So just be careful about using idioms. Okay. Hi everyone, this is Philip from onlineenglishteacher.com. This is Philip from onlineenglishteacher.com. If you have a question, please do ask. And I'm ready to answer any questions anyone may have. UK native speaker and long-term IELTS teacher. I started teaching it about 8 years ago online. And yes, I teach online at the moment. My website is onlineenglishteacher.com. Do check it out. Okay, next tip for the writing exam is make sure that you change the essay vocabulary, or the question vocabulary for task 1. So basically, you know, if the question is you know, what are people's favorite what kind of food is popular? You don't have to say the word food. You could talk about cuisine. You could talk about eating, you know, anything. So sometimes it's a bit hard to change, but then just change, you know, just use their vocabulary once or twice or something like that. So basically, you want to try and avoid repeating their vocabulary. I think is the best one. Okay, and next tip is next tip is make synonyms before you start writing. So for their vocabulary, for the question and task two and task one, make synonyms and so that you're not repeating their vocabulary. Next tip is for task two, you don't need to make like a huge amount of ideas. You could just amazing ideas. You could just use something fairly, you know, basic or whatever, but just make it good. But obviously, many more important things like grammar. But for the task two, I normally say go into a bit of detail, so you're not sort of being too general. So maybe give specifics. I don't just talk about Africa. You could say this country in Africa or something like that. Next tip for writing is, let me think here. Try to not have very short sentences. So, you know, you could make a sentence like 15 to 25 words. But if you have a sentence which is 5 words, I don't think it's going to... I have a message from Alar. Right, hi, Alar. Just in webinar. Right. Right, okay, so I'll just tell that guy that I'm in a webinar. I don't know if he wants to come and listen. A guy from Libya, living in the UK, is a doctor. So I'll put the link here for Alar, and Alaa is his name, and I'm not sure if that's correct pronunciation. There we go. A message from somebody. Message from Emmanuel. I won't give your last name. Still on. Right. For summons. Right. Anyway. Right. Excuse me. So I was getting sidetracked there. I'll come back. Right. Okay. This is someone who's interested in the Skype classes, so check it out, onlineenglishteacher.com, and go ahead if you're interested in that. Right, tip for the writing exam is, and thanks, Emmanuel, for your comments. I'll read through that. Next tip for the writing exam is, you need to... make a schedule. So you think like you're going to be preparing think about how you're going to be, make a schedule. So think about how you're going to be like making synonyms for a few minutes, and then, understanding the question, of course. So, writing, and then checking, making ideas. Make a schedule so you don't run out of time. It won't be very... It won't be very good if you run out of time. I don't know. I've heard of one student I've heard of. I won't say if it was one of mine or someone else. They were very confident for writing, and then they didn't check the time, and they ran out of time. How bad! I feel so sorry for them, we can feel so sorry for them. So basically, check the time, and make sure you don't run out of time. So. Okay, hi everyone, this is Philip from England. If you have a question about the IELTS, please go ahead. And I'm a long-term IELTS teacher, a native speaker. I was born and went to school in the UK. I have lots of free resources, like free forum, free ebook, other free material, lots of that. Also, I have like paid Skype classes, paid writing, paid private forum, paid e-courses, if I didn't mention that. I'm not thinking clearly. Okay, right, so basically I've got Skype classes, or Skype, okay, forget that, if I made a mistake. Skype classes, e-courses, writing homework, and private forum for paying students. Okay, got there eventually. Okay, so, next tip for the IELTS writing, well, we're kind of running out of time. Now, if anyone has a question, please do go ahead and ask. I'm happy to answer. I'll just go some tips for speaking. For the speaking exam, don't speak very fast. Learn useful phrases. Rephrase their question. If they say, "What is a nice tourist activity?" Don't say, "A nice tourist activity is." You can say, "You know, it is popular in my country to visit, you know, whatever, Brighton or whatever the place would be." Right, okay, thank you very much, everyone. If anyone has a question, please go ahead and ask it quickly. Otherwise, I will probably wrap up this, and you can watch it again later. Okay, thank you very much, everyone. It's been my pleasure. This is Philip from onlineenglishteacher.com. If you're interested in any paid services, Skype classes, writing homework, e-courses, or private forum, please let me know. I also have free resources. Let's check if... any questions just coming in? Nothing at the moment. Have a fantastic day.